Hi, and welcome to Playboy's Penthouse. I'm Hugh Hefner, editor publisher of Playboy magazine, and I think you may have met Joan Mattis, who has been here many times before. We're going to have a kind of a fun and special evening tonight. Sammy Davis Jr. will be here in a little while. The Kirby Stone 4 is here. And come on over here and meet very lovely Miss Teddi King, who has the honor, among other things, of being the only girl that ever traveled with the George Shearing quintet, I guess it is. Was it quintet then, too?
It was, and then it became a sextet.
Mm-hmm. Well, I think you're the only girl that ever traveled with a group, and sextet, yeah. A little early in the evening. Teddi, we're going to get you to sing a little something. Joe, could you do something on the
I'd
piano
like
for
to.
Us?
No, Ted, why don't you sit right here? We'll take it from the piano up here.
All right, it's all right. Yeah. Good. Good. We'll get all settled.
You're kind of a pole girl. I don't think you've ever done it with us on the Playboy poll yet, but you've won honors in the Critics poll with Downbeat and Metronome New Talent poll, too, huh?
I've gotten some honorable mentions from you, but
yes, you have.
That's my next goal.
Thank you, dear.
Oh, yeah. Here I come, sound the trumpet and bang the drum. My delectable sugar plum will tumble yet. From today, every scruple is tucked away. I'm the wickedest Salome he's ever met. Many a fine strategic design is brewing beneath my brow. I'm raring to go and feeling as though the devil's in me now. He's cool to me, I can easily guarantee he's on the spot. He'll succumb, sound the trumpet, bang the drum, on to victory. Here I come, ready or not. Though I see at the moment he's cool to me, I can easily guarantee he's on the spot. Yes, he'll succumb, sound the trumpet, bang the drum, on to victory, here I come. Ready, get set, go. Was a time I was his only one, but now I'm the sad and lonely one. Was I gay till today? Now he's a time I was his only one, but now I'm the sad and lonely one. Was I gay? Two.
a satire song that you do on Tennessee Williams? I think the kids would get a big kick out of hearing that. It was really, really decadent.
Well, I'll tell you, actually, you know, there are all kinds of blues songs. And, well, there's a sad blues and then the happy kind of blues you find in Dixieland music, traditional blues, rhythm and blues. The only way that I can describe this thing is to say that it's a very strange blues. Well, it was written by a very strange young man. And his name is Bill Heyer. It goes something like this. It goes exactly like this. I got the Tennessee Williams, Southern decadence blues. I got the Tennessee Williams, Southern decadence blues. And to prove to you I got them, let me give you some clues. I used to think my life was pretty grim. Then I saw some shows by him. Now the whole world's future looks dim. All of Edgar Allan Poe is like a howdy-doody show compared to Sonny Jim. I mean Tennessee, since summer and smoke, I've switched from coke. Whoops. To 5-star Hennessy. Well, I think that there's a tinge of hope in William Inge, right? I mean, he's human. There ain't no doom in Picnic or Bus Stop 2. Dark at the top of the stairs, appeal to all us squares, which doesn't mean he can't be obscene too. But that decadence, that Southern decadence that belongs to you. Old Menacy, Tennessee, you can count on OTW. They kind of shake you up and trouble you. He's found a new shade of blue. Thought I'd certainly admire a streetcar named Desire. Well, I saw it. And let me say to you, he kind of makes you feel that Norman Vincent Peale wrote Eugene O'Neill, played by Howard Keel. When Paddy Chayefsky writes, there ain't no honky-tonks, no movie queen stuck in New Orleans, just the Bronx. What do you feel like doing tonight? I don't know. What do you feel like doing tonight? Marty wasn't arty. It was true. But that decadence, that Southern decadence that belongs to you, sweet Williams, could the hero be any dumber than in suddenly last summer when the natives couldn't date 'em? I got the Tennessee Williams decadence, Southern poverty and Nashville Diners Club blues. Yeah, I got the Tennessee Williams, Southern decadence blues.
Great, gonna have the whole world on a plate, starting here, starting now. Baby, everything's coming up roses. Clear the decks, clear the tracks. We got nothing to do but relax, blow a kiss, take a bow. Baby, everything's coming up roses. Do 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 do. Now's our inning. Stand the world on its ear. We gotta set it spin. just the beginning. Curtain up, light the lights. We got nothing to hit but the heights. We'll be swell, we'll be great. I can tell, just you wait. That lucky star I talk about is two. Baby, everything's coming up. Roses for me and for you, 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 me and you. Pa 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 pa.
Well, I don't think these fellas really require introduction. It's the wonderful Kirby Stone Quartet, and it's a ball to have you here.
Well, thanks. It's the same with
this
us.
This is a swinging group and swinging guys, too. And
I wanted to ask you something. Did you notice the harmony we used there?
Yeah, I
you like
appreciate
it?
Oh, yeah, I like the sound you
see,
do.
See, most people don't pay attention. I mean, we go, here, we'll show you. Give us an F chord.
Pick me a spot.
And they just sit. This uh-huh. takes work, Hugh. For instance, I sing the lead. I go, I do the lead. I go, pick me a spot. And Poison sings the high part.
Pick me a spot.
Wait, it don't fit now, but when you put the chord together, it works. Larry sings the bass.
Pick me a spot.
And Mike right in the middle.
Pick me a spot.
And when you put it together, it gels.
Pick me a spot.
Modern.
That's very progressive.
It's a new sound.
Tell you what, we'll do something without harmony. Do you think you'd enjoy a love song?
That'd be very nice.
Okay, we have
very
a love song, nice. Not about guys, not about gals. A love song about snakes.
He was a rattlesnake known as Hector. He had a gal named Diamondback Lou. When he promised to love and protect her, they sighed, they kissed, and here's what he hissed as she whispered, I love you. It's wonderful. It's marvelous. You should care. For me, it's awful nice, it's paradise, it's what I long to see.
You made my life so glamorous. You can't blame me for feeling amorous.
It's wonderful. Hector had a love affair swinging, and he went hissing along, cause snakes ain't much for singing. She's a very young snake, Hector didn't have much hope, cause he was a nearsighted snake, and he fell in love with a long hunk of rope. So Hector got himself a pair of contact lenses, and he made another try. But what Lou thought was the flame of love was just a plate glass look in his eye. They had a fine romance, they loved each other body and soul. They even learned how to dance, to shake, rattle and roll. Shake, rattle and roll. You made my life so glamorous.
You can't blame me for feeling amorous.
It's wonderful. Marvelous that you should care for me. Do do do.
When I say a love song about snakes, I want you to know this is not lightly taken. I do want to mention one disappointing point of view, though. We've watched the show so many times and are happy to be on it, but why don't you ever get something real swinging like rock and roll?
Yeah.
Well, no, I don't know what you mean by oh. Well, there's rock and roll and there's rock and roll. We can do it rather well.
That's right.
Uh-huh.
May we?
Of course.
All right. Hey, Joe, here's a kick.
We're lucky. Everybody say it.
There you go. A little rock and roll. A one, two, three, four.
We take you now to London, England, and the Palladium, where rock and roll has really taken over. And standing by are the new sensations in the entire United Kingdom, the Percival Fink Four, with their rock and roll version of the St. Louis Blues. So take it away, London.
Oh, how I hate to see that nocturnal Sunday's here.
Hooray for our side. Have a go. I say give it what for.
He's a very fancy singer.
Oh, how I hate to see that nocturnal sun descend. Is this too jazzy for you? For it recalls the departure of my favorite female friend. See there, if you wait long enough, it's got the plot and everything.
Yes.
Now then, Piccadilly woman.
That's my favorite part right there. That's the way I am.
And well, it should be, because that Piccadilly woman is from a tender old British expression, goes like this. You pick what you want, and we'll Piccadilly. I got it. That was a good one. You weren't ready for that, eh? Perhaps you ought to give them a touch of British humour.
Righto.
If you enjoy this. Mummy, I'm almost 15 years old now. When may I start wearing lip rouge? Possibly never, Bruce. Now, here's the part you've all been waiting for. The part you Americans love. Rock and roll.
Rock and roll.
Of course, in London, we call it stone and bun. However, it's quite...
Possibly never, Bruce. I say.
I'm glad that got around to you. Now, like we said before, rock and roll. Joe, you ready? Good boy. Here we go. The excitement runs rife as we perform rock. I feel so good. You've got to go, 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 everybody.
Go, go.
Bloody wild, what?
Go, go. To the beastly British blue.
Well, thank you very much. It's a pleasure being at this party, and it's always an extreme pleasure entertaining you folks living here in the colonies. Now,
here.
They'll never get the miserable loot back here. How about if we swing one, okay? Come on, 2, 3, go! Yeah. Up a lazy river by the old mill run. That lazy river in the noonday sun. You linger in the shade of a candle tree.
Throw away your troubles, dream a dream with me.
Up a lazy river where the robin song invites a morning we can loaf along.
Blue skies above, everybody's in love.
Up that lazy river, how happy we can be. Up a lazy river with me.
One more time. Lazy river by the old mill run. Lazy river in the noonday sun. Little linger in the shade of an old pine tree. Oh man, trouble, get away from me.
We got that last note from the high-lows. I just wanted to, it was kind of a borrowed thing. One thing that disturbs us mightily is the fact that an act or a vocal group gets a hit record and everybody jumps on it. This particular song was recorded, introduced right here in Chicago over 20 years ago by the best quartet in show business, the Mills Brothers. They did it this way. Watch.
Up a lazy river by the old mill run. Well, yeah.
We don't like to cool him. For a long time, he used to play comb and tissue paper in a gypsy restaurant. It's one of those things. But here's what we mean. People that have no province, they shouldn't sing songs like this. Romantic singers, for instance, like Billy Daniels. All right, here we go.
Oh, get it. Up a lazy river by the old mill run. Well, I crazy the river in the noonday sun. You just think of it, shame.
Sometimes you can get hit making the next announcement. We did want to tell, for those of you that like statistics, Billy Daniels did not become a star by making records.
Right.
Or by singing. He did it with a wild sound. Can you do that?
I'd love to.
Now watch out. This gets out of hand sometimes. The wild sound of Billy Daniels. Go, baby. Oh.
I can't do it.
Don't be a drag.
Now
wait.
Warm up a little. Go, baby. Get in. Here it comes now, the wild sound of Billy Daniels. Oh. There it is, Pat.
That's not wild. That's just a little guess. Here's a wild sound, the sound of Tony Martin.
Up a lazy river where the robin's song invites a bright new morning we can get along. Blue skies above, everybody's in love. La,
course you recognize. You won't recognize the one on the left. That's his partner, little Sidney Charisse. You were good. I wanted to. Since rock and roll has been having its problems, we've needed a new leader in singing, and we have one this year. The golden voice of Mr. Magoo.
I believe you're everybody. I can't you tell you're all out here tonight. Playing around, blow the horn, ring the bell. Happy New Year, Waldo.
Here comes my boy, Sammy Davis Jr. Sammy boy.
Punch him a shot in the mouth.
Oh, boy. I mean, hold it, hold it.
I mean, I just don't think it's right for me. His nose is not as flat as mine. I tell you what, now that I'm in, it's like a group here now.
Right.
Now, one more time.
All right.
Fair enough. The old mill run. A lazy, lazy river in the midday sun. You linger in the shade of a crop on tree.
I'd like to say
hey, you.
A lazy river where the robin song so low. And we can get along.
Hey!
Blue skies above, everybody's in love.
Go!
Up a lazy river with me.
You laughing?
Hey, listen, Morty. Morty, I don't think. Hey, guys. Excuse me. I think it's only fair since we're drinking this booze that we should meet the man who is sponsoring this thing. The man who's my buddy, Hugh Hefner. This is Morty Stevens, my conductor.
Hi.
This is George Rhodes.
George.
Hi, Johnny Mendoza.
Hi. Yeah.
Michael.
Yes. Cool it for a minute. This is Hugh Hefner.
Sticks and all.
Michael, sorry. We got the whole
he carries
group.
Carries them everywhere.
Every place he goes. Why don't you tinkle on the piano a little bit? Maybe it might be kind
yeah,
of.
Yeah. And why don't you sing a little bit, Sam?
Oh well, I got a problem. You see. If I was to sing, see, I'm used to singing with like 94 pieces, you know? Mm-hmm. And I only brought four guys with me. Michael, I tell you what to do. Why don't you go over to the bar and find out if there's any wine for my men over there? Bring one back for me.
All right.
And Morty, I got an idea. Dig, like at these kind of parties, right? They always have like, this, you don't know this man. He's got a hi-fi setup like you've never seen. He's got all kinds of records, hundreds of them. So he must have some of those join in and sing type records, you know, where they just have the musical background.
Oh, yeah.
Sure, sure. Go over to the hi-fi set and see if you can find some.
On the other side of the wall.
You get over by the piano by George and see? Be prepared to do anything. We might attack Castro. It's not that. Just might wipe him out, Johnny. Now let's go over here. Come on, let's see what Morty's found, huh? I'm gonna get you. Your nose is gonna be as flat as mine. Hold it. Hold it. Look at this. A little gift. A little gift for friends. You find something?
I sure did, Sam. Let me put it on.
Okay, put it on.
You know how to run this?
Do I know how to run? Are you? You're not talking to like an out-of-town buyer.
Mm-hmm.
I know. It's got all. Look at this, a Sherwood with a double tweeter. It's. How do you turn it on? Just tell me how to turn it on, and we'll cool it.
Try this
one. Okay. Now over one to Wilco.
We're getting Mars here.
Yeah.
I don't hear any sound.
Well, cool it. You'll hear it in a minute. It's gonna come up as soon as it warms up. It's gotta.
Yeah. There we go. Sounds like one of your arrangements, I think.
Isn't it wonderful to have my arrangements on the
Playboy?
The night is bitter. The stars have lost their glitter. Wind grows colder. Suddenly you're older. And all because of the gal that got away. No more her eager call. The writing's on the wall. The dreams you dreamed have all gone astray.
not won you has run off and undone you. That great beginning has seen a final inning. Don't know what happened. It's such a crazy game. No more that all-time thrill. For you've been through the mill. And never a new love will ever be the same. Good riddance, goodbye. Every trick of hers, you're on to. But fools will be fools, and where she goes. Tomorrow she may turn up. There's just no let up. To live a long night and day. For every since the world began, there is nothing sadder than a one man woman looking for his chick that got away. The gal that got away, she's the gal that got away. Suit dooby doo ya da dee dooba dooby doo wee.
That's wonderful, Marty. That's, the way the band waited for me with the record, that was wonderful while I conducted. I think, I tell you, do. You know, the Hugh, you know, the leader, Sinatra, has got a song that he's been doing for quite some time. And I finally got an album that I think I'm kind of proud of. I don't plug albums because I ain't had a hit in so long, it's ridiculous, you know. I'm too old to have a hit, I'm 34. We did an album with Basie's band. We can't put Basie's name on the cover or anything because of his connections, you know, with the other company, Roulette. But it's all of the Basie guys, and it's the leader's song. So we might as well do one of these. Huh? I wine, dan, don, don, mulligan, stew. I never wish for turkey as I hitched and I hiked and I drifted too. From Maine to Albuquerque, at last I missed the Bozarts ball. What is twice as sad, I was never at a party where they honored Noel Kahn. But her social circles spin too fast for me. Hark, I thought I heard a pistol shot. My home Bohemia is the place I wanna be. She gets too hungry for dinner at 8. She loves the theater, but refuses to arrive late. She will never bother with some cat that she hates. And that is why the lady is a tramp. Won't go to Coney, any beach is divine. She takes the ball games, but the bleachers are fine. She reads Kilgallen, and I mean every line. That's why the lady is a tramp. She likes that free, fresh, shows and stamps. That's why the lady is a that free, fresh wind in her hair, life without care. She is grown, but it's home. Hates California. It's cold and it's damp. That's why the lady is a tramp. Why the lady? That kooky, kooky.
The only problem about getting a ham like me up at a party, you, is that the guy invariably keeps going on and on. I know you got a lot of things. I don't want to, like, intrude, but could I do a medley of my hit?
Yes, please.
Could I? It will only take a minute. let me see what we can do for... Why don't we do a combination of some of the things? George. Morty, would you find out if they've got, like, some of the records on... Would you get the band together, Morty, for this, please? I'd appreciate it if you would. Give me a little thing there, would you?
Something you have to give.
Yeah, that's right. Good. Yeah. Yeah. When an irresistible force such as you
meets an old immovable object like me,
storing up food for the winter, eh? You can give. That's something really gotta give. After watching her appeal from every angle, there's a big dramatic deal I gotta wangle. For I've fallen for a certain lovely lass. And it's not a passing fancy, or a fancy bird. I love the looks of you, the lore of you. I'd like to make a tour of you. The eyes and the heart and the love of you. The east, west, north and the south of you. I'd love to gain complete control of you and handle even the heart and soul of you. So love at least a small percent of me, do. 'Cause I love all of you. Skidoo-doo-doo, skilly-a-da-dow. 'Cause I love all of you. One quiet song. We've been, like, too loud. Now, I have to get... If this was a movie, see, we'd, like, have a setting. So I have to get a setting. Cigarette?
Nice!
funny Valentine. Sweet comic Valentine, you make me smile with my heart. Your looks are laughable. Yet you're my favorite work of art. Is your figure less than Greek? Is your mouth a little weak? When are you smart? Pretty. So don't change your hair for me. Not if you care for me. Stay. Valentine's Day.
Wonderful, Morty. I was thinking. Thank you. Chad, I don't want to, like, put the party down or anything.
Oh, hello there, Victoria. Yeah.
How are you?
You didn't get a chance before, but this is George Rhodes, my pianist. This is Victor Lowndes.
Hi, Vic.
And this is Finus Henderson, and this is George's wife. You know, George's wife. And Marty's over conducting the band.
You mean playing the records?
Playing the records, I mean. Oh, son of a gun. But, you know, I would like to explain to all the guys at the gals at the party that my relationship with Victor and Hugh goes back quite a ways. I'm still waiting for the day. I dream nightly of the day that I might win the jazz poll.
It's your buddy.
Yeah, my buddy wins all the time, doesn't he? That dirty rat. Anyway, I'm only kidding, of course. Everybody should know this. This is Chicago, and I think it's only appropriate if you don't think it's a little too square. Marty did an arrangement on Chicago, which you just happen to have in your library of records. I think would be wonderful to do at this time. Chicago, Chicago, that toddling town, the toddling town. Chicago, Chicago, let me take you around. I bet your bottom dolly you lose the blues in Chicago, Chicago, the town that Billy Sunday could not close down. On Great Street, that's State Street. I just want to say, allow me to say that we do things that they wouldn't do on Broadway. Hey, why you laugh the time of your life? I saw a man and he danced with his wife in Chicago. Man, my hometown. We got a great street called State Street. I just want to say, allow me to say that we do things that they wouldn't do on Broadway. Hey, why you laugh the time of your life? I saw a man and he danced with his wife in Chicago. Man, my hometown. We got a great street called State Street. I just want to say, allow me to say that we do things that they wouldn't do on Broadway. Hey, why?
find the time of your life. Just make sure that you bring your wife. You can keep Las Vegas. Give me the Playboy in Chicago. And this is my home town.
Yeah. Yeah. Let's get some booze for the crowd. Come on, you. Buy me a drink, will you?
It's been too much. May I salute you all? Mm. May I thank you for being such a beautiful party type thing? And you're too much. You better get your nose flattened, Daddy. You're in a lot of trouble. I gotta go. Are my guys ready? Morty?
Yeah.
Johnny Mendoza? Michael Silver? George, you ready? We gotta split.
Back to the Shea. Huh?
We have to go back to the Shea. Thank you for being so nice. Goodbye.
God, he's got almost no
fanny. Why not? Why not? Why not, Bubby?
He's gonna do he's gonna do voices, which I won't. This is not a contest. But I can't leave like myself, you know. Let me leave like let me see who would leave. Cary Grant, right? I'd like to say it's been wonderful to be here with you, charming ladies. It's really been great, and I'm going to leave you now. It's been fun. I'll see you later. But he'd never get up the steps. I know that. I have that feeling. Cagney. It's been wonderful, really great, to have been here with you nice people. I'm gonna leave you now. See you later. You know, and maybe you're, let me see, Marlon Brando.
Mm-hmm. Look, I'd like to say that's been wonderful, you know. It's been a real swinging party, and are you a good guy? You
know? Nah, but I can't do that. I think it's. Come on, do one for us, lad. Come on, do one.
I think that this is the nicest place I've ever been to.
You do Karloff, and I'll do Igor.
Fix my neck now for me.
Holy feet, this is quite a weird place. There's no bats. All day, no bats.
All day. Listen, now, let me ask you one question before I leave.
Did somebody call for a bat? I just want to let you know you'll all have to stay. The bridge is washed out.
I'm gonna split, because I really have to. The guys are waiting for me.
Listen, so Sam, what? Before you go, I got something for you. You've been such a sweet and wonderful guy to come up and entertain us. Well, you stay here.
Okay.
Wow, he brings me the center folder of Playboy.
That'd be the swingiest gift he could give me.
With fur.
With
my goodness gracious.
His name is Playboy.
And
in a year, he's going to be bigger than you are.
Hello, Playboy.
Hugh, this is beautiful. This is what I really wanted, and this is the God's honest truth.
Look at that little face. Up one. You belong to me. I'm your daddy now.
I've had many people call me a dog. Now I can prove it.
You got a cold nose? You love me? Give me a little kiss. Give me a little kiss. There we go.
No. I'll take care. Well, listen, if you're going to give me this, then there's only one way I know how to exit with you. And that is very simple. We got a great street called State Street. I just want to say, allow me to say that we do things that they wouldn't do on Broadway. Hey, why, you'll have the time of your life. I'm so glad that I brought my wife. Las Vegas. Chicago, that's my home. That's the closet. Let me walk into the closet.
What do you say after an evening like this, except that we've had an awfully good time, and we hope that you have, too. We're going to be back here again next week, same time on Playboy's Penthouse. We hope that you can join us. I'd like to, because it's been such a special evening, give special credit verbally to some of the people that made it possible tonight. First of all, the wonderful, wonderful talent, the people that came up and entertained all of us, Teddi King, the Kirby Stone 4, and of course, Sammy Davis Jr., who's just a little bit of too much. Sammy comes to us through the courtesy of the Will Maston Trio, his father and uncle, with whom he no longer works, but is still billed. Sammy Davis Group was under the baton of Morty Stevens. It was the Henry Brandon Orchestra. And in addition to that, playing with Sammy was Johnny Mendoza on bongos, Michael Silva, the drummer, George Rhodes, piano. The show, as always, is produced and directed by Dan Shuffman, associate producer Victor Lowndes III, talent coordinator Benny Dunn. Hairstyles for the show are by Mr. John of Talk of the Town, Highland Park. Furnishings by Ducks of California and John R. Willis, Chicago. We also enjoyed the background music of Joe Parnello Trio. The associate director was Phil Bondelli. Production supervisor, Bob Link. Technical director, Roger Sanchi. Video, Hugh Perkins. Audio, Bud Marcus. And the stage manager, Dick Ortner. And this is Hugh Hefner, editor-publisher of Playboy magazine. And our little friend, Joan Mattis, who, want to say goodnight? Saying again goodnight, and we hope to see you here again next week, same time.
Can we go out and see what the people are doing?